update you all. I'm Kevin Williams with today's Go News Now solution. Yes, today's solution is for the U.S. healthcare system and insurance industry, and that's a full bed tray. When was the last time you heard someone proclaim their full satisfaction and complete thrill with their healthcare insurance? How about the wonderful and quick visit to an emergency room? You likely have never heard such proclamations if you are a U.S. citizen, which means, unlike every other industrialized country, your country, the United States, does not provide you with insurance and healthcare. France, England, Canada, Australia, and many more, all their citizens are covered in full for any and all cases of illness, injury, prescriptions, tests, and preventative medicine. Did you know that? And did you also know how incredibly successful those countries are at it? And how many totally satisfied citizens there are in those countries? Just about all of them. And that includes a number of Americans who have relocated to those countries for any one of a number of reasons, only to find a perfectly running government-financed public healthcare system. Are you jealous? Well, if you have a knot in your stomach or you're feeling some pain right now, you better not go get it checked out over at the ER unless you can afford the deductible, of course. But they still may classify it as a pre-existing condition. Perhaps that Twinkie you ate about 20 years ago. In fact, they'll probably drop you as more of a high-risk snacker. But the reality can be just as ludicrous, and many people, perhaps you, live with a constant fear of getting sick and the terror you may face at the mercy of the existing healthcare insurers. We are all stuck between a kidney stone and a hard place. Here's a look, right now, at what the current U.S. healthcare system is doing to our entire economy. It ain't pretty. What has happened is that we've been duped into a stupor and brainwashed to believe that we have a legitimate competitive choice in healthcare providers, and that premiums and benefits have been kept under control by a free market competition, and we should feel lucky to have what they offer. Hence, the giant sucking sound in the economy. The medical monopoly gripping this country at all public and political levels is a finely tuned profit machine designed to probe and prod as much profit from your precious pocket as possible. Ow, God. Just twisted my tongue. It's probably going to be like a $500 deductible. Now, at these recent town haller meetings, also known as Screamapaloozas, you're deafened by a crazed group of misinformed, whiny, right wingnuts whose razor-thin understanding of the proposed healthcare bills have been wheezed out of the media kindergarten named Fox News, or vasectomized out of the nutless wonder Rush Limbaugh. These tunnel-visioned beer gutters are all mouth and no ears. But their misinformed misunderstanding and unwittingly self-destructive activism cannot steamroll the greater will of the vast majority of better-informed people in the country who want national health care now. We're talking like right now. They no longer want to be the odd country out while the rest of the industrialized world whizzes past the U.S., leaving us way back at the ass end of the pack of healthy nations, like where we now stand at an astonishing 37th in infant mortality. That's 37th. Rather than a Hippocratic Oath, most politicians have apparently sworn to a hypocritic oath, a deliberately chosen hypocrisy where they can somehow support and pay for an illegal war for $2.5 trillion, but cannot find somehow in their hearts a way to pay less than half of that to provide every man, woman, and child in this country an honest, solid, and world-class healthcare system. What the fuck are they thinking? Oh yeah, I've got it. They're thinking about all the lobbyist dollars, tens of millions of them, that they received to run for office, and the tens of millions they're going to need again to run in 2010 and 2012. These so-called representatives of the people are representatives of something else. They represent the flaw in our society and our politics, blatantly showing how we have failed to teach our children and ourselves the difference between what's right and what's wallet. So of course they're going to save their own political careers' butts at your expense. What, sacrifice their job by being underfunded in the next election by big pharma and insurance industries? You betcha. Rather than propose any solution that the public really wants or needs, and most people voted for in the last election, rather than representing the will of the people and doing the right thing, these pawns will cower and succumb to their bribers, I mean lobbyists, thereby upholding a widely held view that most politicians are nothing more than two-faced opportunists walking a tightrope between selfish career perpetuation and honestly representing the people who put them in their present so precious position. Jeez, that's twice. My deductible's gonna be gone. So they'll choose to defend their bribers and forcibly guard the status quo by spreading myths and promoting lies to create fear in the underinformed sheeple. Fear, the same pathetic little card they play over and over again through mouth holes at Fox News and Rush Lamebutt, who can and will say anything and be held accountable by no one. They'll fire up and spew lies to spark up mass and, yes, legitimate anger, legitimate anger based upon illegitimate lies. How's that not in your stomach? Twinkie lives on. Here's the solution we have been waiting for. You ready? Like Medicare, which if you've forgotten, is a wholly government-run program that works exceptionally well. A government-run healthcare plan must be created and funded now, right now. And did I mention now? The strain imposed on our economy and citizens under the thumb of the current medical monopoly is too large for any further delay. The giant medical megacorporation monopoly need to be prodded to think outside their greed boxes and formulas, and sorry, we don't cover that mindset, and get real. We're all fed up with them, and those that say they aren't have not seen the other side of the rainbow found in the other countries' healthcare systems, where even flying monkeys and munchkins can get covered. Oh, and if you happen to be one of those town hall scream piles, keep in mind that munchkins and flying monkeys are not real, but the universal coverage in those countries is. Now, we can take the best from each of them and make a wholly new system that will put the U.S. right up at the top of the healthcare universe. Just imagine our excitement when we get everyone the coverage they need to protect and promote all life and reverse the medical monopoly which has brainwashed the country and brought the media and Congress to their knees. The United States has an unfortunate pre-existing condition, the medical monopoly. Doctors and patients have a prescription for them. It's an easy in-house procedure, one in which all of those companies' greedy little heads are surgically removed from their corporate asses. I'm Kevin Williams, and this is GoNewsNOW. Like right now. Now. Did I mention now?